Well, good evening everyone, and I don't know if you hear the music in the background, but I just wanted you to listen to this. Carnaval is arriving, well actually in about a month, and everyone is rehearsing, and it's like that every single night, and it will be like that until Carnaval Day. So yeah, at least it's entertaining. So today I thought I should talk about women. Because a few things have emerged which have made me think a little bit. First of all is really about how do you include women in projects like the one that I'm working on. So out of a group of 8, we have only one lady, and it took a lot of time to find her. She's great, her name is Islin, and I really like her, but this week she hasn't been attending the training. So I had to call and leave messages that didn't go anywhere. So I asked one of the guys to try to go and see her and phone people in his family because he knows her. And I finally got a letter this morning where she very nicely apologized, saying that she had to go to university because one of her teachers from Port-au-Prince had especially come and it clashed with the lessons. So she was going to come back next week. So hey, hooray! I have my my one and only woman in the group. I don't think that I will be able to put her on the street. I don't think she wants to be a guide, but that's really what I would like. So hey, here it is. This is my first question. How do you recruit women on a pro-poor tourism project, which is exactly what's happening here, if they don't want to take part? You really have to be persistent in trying to make sure that they're staying. And it's, you know, I would have expected, and I did ask her, please call me or give me a time at which I can call you back if you don't have credit on your phone, but even that doesn't work. Even after the letter I received, I sent a text and I said, oh please, you know, tell me when I can call you and then we can have a little chat before you come back on Monday. But that even, she's not responding to it. So I've got no idea. Maybe I should jump on my motorbike and go and see her. But if she comes back, I'm going to be very happy. The other thing that was very interesting as well yesterday, apropos women, was a little discussion that I had with my guides. And that's actually, that's really why I need a woman in the group, because I need a woman to kick bums and to make sure that those boys know what to do and be on their best appropriate behavior. But we were making a list of all the criteria that a guide needs to meet in order to be professional. So we were talking about behavior, about knowledge, and of course the subject of sex came up. So the question was, do we have the right to have sex with our clients? So that was an interesting one. So we had a little debate, and of course you can imagine that the conclusion was that not at all, but we still had to kind of argue the point that it was not okay either to have sex if a woman client was asking them. I think they kind of had an issue with them wanting to have a relationship with the woman, and that they understood that that was inappropriate, but they still thought that if the woman was asking, that was okay. So I did have to put my foot down and explain that it wasn't, and that it would really affect our reputation, that's the word, especially as there are a lot of women that are traveling alone here because they come and work for NGOs. So I really want to create an atmosphere whereby the women feel that they can trust the guides 100%. So, you know, you think that this is it, they get the message and they all say, yes, we didn't know, now we know, that's fantastic. We're you know, very happy with that. And then about 15 minutes after we have the little chat, I do an activity with them about their hobbies, because I thought that if I knew more about their hobbies, I could maybe match the type of excursions that they want to guide better to their hobbies and to their passions. So everything goes very well, you know, they all do their little activity. But I had a very interesting answer from one of them. So I have to stress out, this is the exception, yes, but it does prove that actually, again, I can't make any assumptions that the message has gone through. And his second hobby after I think going to the beach was to have sex. And I had a table that says, "What is your hobby? Details." So I'm glad to know that he has sex 4 times a week at the hotel or in his house with his amoureuse, which is a really lovely word for the woman who he loves and who loves him. And the reason to have that hobby is because it meets his physiological needs, sorry. So that was also very interesting. So obviously I need to have another little chat about the appropriateness of certain information to give to people that you do not know. But I'm glad to say that it's only one of them. But it kind of shows, again. And then the last bit that I wanted to speak about was a visit that I made yesterday with 3 of my guys. We're developing together a kind of gastronomy excursion or food theme excursion. And we went to a place called Apladem, which is a place where a bunch of women under the management of a super entrepreneur. I mean, this woman is totally amazing. She started from scratch and saw that a lot of fruits were wasted in her village. So she decided to actually do the what we call, you know, food transformation, food processing, and create products out of these fruits to create and give jobs to the women that didn't have work in her village. She's totally inspiring. So the guys that I had with me, they were in awe of her. She spoke to us, explained all her story. She was voted Entrepreneur of the Year, you know, in Haiti last year. And what we're going to do with her, she has this food processing plant. We're going to take the tourist and she's going to teach the tourist how to make mango liquor, mango syrup, mango marmalade, and hopefully maybe mango chips. We will see if we have the time to do that. So on Tuesday morning, we will go to her workshop, and she will do a trial of the excursion to see how it works. So I'm very much looking forward to it. She makes wonderful things like this thing, which I'm going to drink. So here it is. It comes in this kind of packaging, I don't know if you can all see it, hopefully. This is actually made by a girl in a village who is selling them in order to finance her education. So again, a fantastic little story here. And what I was drinking was liqueur de café, so this is coffee liqueur, and it's absolutely delicious. And she produces loads of different liqueurs from all sorts of different fruits here. I mean, I've never seen so many different fruits here. Today I had cherry juice, fresh cherry juice. I have grapefruit juice every single day. It's really wonderful. So the potential to actually teach about the local cuisine here and to tell people how it's made, it's great. But also the fact that we can do that, knowing that we're giving work to women, I think that's even better. And what really, really made me happy is that the guys that were with me, they were all men, and they were really enthusiastic about doing this project. So, hey, here we are. So, that is it for tonight. I'm going to continue listening to the wonderful carnival music, and until next time, bye-bye.